Students, in this video we'll learn Keeping Quiet by Pablo Neruda. In this presentation we'll discuss theme, summary and line for line explanation of the poem Keeping Quiet. Let's listen to an audio recording of the poem.
Keeping Quiet by Pablo Neruda. Now we will count to 12 and we will all keep still. For once on the face of the earth, let's not speak in any language. Let's stop for 1 second and not move our arms so much. It would be an exotic moment, without rush, without engines. We would all be together in a sudden strangeness. Fishermen in the cold sea would not harm whales, and the man gathering salt would look at his hurt hands. Those who prepare green wars, wars with gas, wars with fire, victory with no survivors, would put on clean clothes and walk about with their brothers in the shade, doing nothing. What I want should not be confused with total inactivity. Life is what it is about. I want no truck with death. If we were not so single-minded about keeping our lives moving and for once could do nothing, perhaps a huge silence might interrupt the sadness of never understanding ourselves and of threatening ourselves with death. Perhaps the earth can teach us, as when everything seems dead and later proves to be alive. Now I'll count up to 12 and you keep quiet and I will go.
The poem has been written by Pablo Neruda. Pablo Neruda, it's a Spanish name, was born on July 12, 1904 and died on September 23, 1973. He was a poet. His pen name was Pablo Neruda. And later, his legal name was Neftali Ricardo Reyes Basualto. He was a Chilean poet, diplomat and politician. He chose his pen name after the Czech poet Jan Neruda. In 1971, Neruda won the Nobel Prize for Literature. Let's now discuss the theme of the poem, Keeping Quiet. It's a plea to mankind. Plea means a request, an urge. The poem is an urge to mankind. It's a plea to mankind. The poem questions the way we move through our lives without pausing or caring for the world around us, the suffering of nature, the world and other people. Human beings are busy 24/7 in making materialistic progress. We hardly stop and introspect. We do not look around us at the suffering of Mother Nature, the world, and the sufferings of other people. The poem also criticizes the divisive tendency of man. For example, people speak in different languages, which creates a divide. For example, people speaking Gujarati would love to live with or interact with the people speaking in Gujarati instead of the people speaking in Punjabi or Tamil. Languages creates divides. We would all be together in a sudden strangeness if the whole world keeps silent and still for 12 seconds. There will be a sudden and strange feeling of togetherness. In this way, the poem criticizes the divisive tendency of human beings. It gives a message of peace, brotherhood, and togetherness. The poem also chastises, scolds mankind for murder of animals and other men, and remind them of victory with no survivors. Human beings are preparing weapons of mass destruction like nuclear bombs and biological weapons. If wars are fought with these deadly weapons, no human being would be left to see or celebrate the victory. So this victory would be without any survivors. The poem also gives a message to cleanse oneself of all guilt and hatred. There's a line in the poem which reads, "Put on clean clothes and walk about with their brothers." We have to come clean of our guilt and hatred, and we have to spread the message of brotherhood. We have to walk arm in arm with our fellow human beings. Now we'll discuss the poem line for line. Now we'll count to 12 and we'll all keep still. The poem begins in a very dramatic way. It is an exotic and unusual beginning of a poem. The poet speaks to the readers and introduces a sort of game. The poet will count to 12 and we all have to keep still. For once on the face of the earth, let's not speak in any language. Let's stop for 1 second and not move our arms so much. The poet makes a request to the readers. What is the request? He wants us to be silent. He does not want us to speak in any language. Not speaking in any language is very significant. We all know that languages divide human beings. They segregate people on the basis of language. People speaking French will feel more intimate in the company of other French speaking people. Similarly, German speaking people or Portuguese speaking people would love to spend time with the people who speak in their own language. A language is one's national and cultural identity. So, if human beings don't speak in any language, there will be a feeling of unity and togetherness. The message of brotherhood would be spread far and wide. Let's stop for 1 second and not move our arms so much. The second request made by the poet is that we, the readers, we, the people of the world, should not move our arms. We have to keep still. We should not make any movement. Now there is a pun in arms here. Arms means body parts, and arms also refers to weapons. In that way, the poet urges the human beings to stop making wars. He wants the readers to end all conflicts. At least for 12 seconds, we can keep silent and still. And the poet is very firm that it will solve all the problems of the world. The poet wants us to count 12 and keep still and silent. Silent means we should not speak in any language. Still means we should not move our arms. There is a pun in arms. It means body parts and weapons. It would be an exotic moment without rush, without engines. We would all be together in a sudden strangeness. This moment would be an exotic moment. Exotic means unusual or rare. Which moment would be exotic? The moment when all the people of the world keep silent and still. That moment would be an exotic moment. Without rush. There would be no rush. People would not run. They would not be in a hurry. There would be no crowds anywhere. Without engines. The engines would also stop. Normally we see that roads are full of vehicles. Their engines are on, running. But if people keep silent and still for 12 seconds, there would be no sound of engines. There would be no rush. We would all be together in a sudden strangeness. It would be a very strange moment. And all the human beings would have a sudden and strange feeling of togetherness and unity. There would be a feeling of brotherhood. All conflicts would end. There would be no hatred in the world. Every single human being would feel that all other human beings are his brothers and sisters. We would and sudden strangeness here are examples of alliteration. Alliteration is a poetic device in which initial consonant sounds are repeated in a sequence of nearby words and syllables. For example, we would, were sound is repeated here. Sudden strangeness, sir, sound is repeated here. So we would and sudden strangeness are examples of alliteration. You can see normal human life, vehicles running, rushing, engines running in full steam, railway stations, subways crowded with people, people jostling and elbowing one another. But if people keep silent and still for 12 seconds, this would be an exotic moment. Roads would be without any vehicles. Railway stations would be empty. And there would be a sudden and strange feeling of brotherhood, unity, and peace. Fishermen in the cold sea would not harm whales, and the man gathering salt would look at his hurt hands. His hurt hands is another example of alliteration. And fishermen here are symbolic of those people who exploit nature for own selfish motives. If fishermen keep silent and still for 12 seconds, they would realize their mistake and they would stop harming or killing whales in the cold sea. In that way, we'll be able to protect nature. And if the man gathering salt keeps silent and still for 12 seconds, he would look at his injured hands, hurt hands. Actually, he gathers salt without using any protective equipment like rubber boots or gloves. But if he keeps silent and still for 12 seconds, he would look at his hands which have been injured due to exposure to salt. He would realize his mistake. He would realize that he is hurting himself in the process of earning money. So he would take some protection to save his hands. You can see a rash, thoughtless fisherman kills whales. Man gathers salt without any protective equipment. He is exposed to salt. As a result, his hands are hurt. But if the fisherman and the man gathering salt keep silent and still for 12 seconds, they would realize their mistake. They would introspect and retrospect and find out what wrong they are doing. So after keeping silent and still, they would stop harming nature and themselves. The fishermen would not kill whales, and the man gathering salt would use some protective equipment. Those who prepare green wars, wars with gas, wars with fire, victory with no survivors, would put on clean clothes and walk about with their brothers in the shade doing nothing. Those refers to warmongers. Warmongers means the people who prepare for wars, like biologists, they prepare biological weapons, scientists, they prepare nuclear weapons, gas weapons, state heads, prime ministers, presidents, military men, generals, chiefs of defense forces. These people are warmongers. They prepare for war, and they mainly prepare for three types of wars. Green wars. Green wars means either war against nature or war fought with biological weapons like germs, viruses. Like these days, many countries are blaming China that they have prepared this COVID-19 virus in lab to take revenge upon other countries. Wars with gas. Gas can also be used as a weapon. It was used as a weapon in World War II. Wars with fire. It refers to wars fought with nuclear weapons. When nuclear weapons are exploded, a huge ball of fire is seen. Victory with no survivors. These people will of course be victorious, but there would be nobody left in the world to see or celebrate that victory. So their efforts are futile. They will win, but they won't be able to survive to see the victory. If these people keep silent and still for 12 seconds, they would realize their mistake. They would introspect and feel that wars are useless. They are destructive and disastrous. They do not bring any good to humanity. So what would they do? They would put on clean clothes. Clean clothes is an example of alliteration. Clean clothes here is very significant. Their clothes are stained with blood, not literally but metaphorically. They have been preparing for wars, so their clothes are stained with the blood of those who have died in wars. These people would change clothes, they would put on clean clothes and walk about with their brothers in the shade. Brothers here does not refer to blood relations. Brothers means all the human beings, men and women. These people would realize their mistake and they would make peace with their enemies. They would walk in the shade, not in the sunlight in the battlefield. They would walk in the shade with their fellow human beings, arm in arm, and they would do nothing. Doing nothing is very significant here. Doing nothing here refers to doing nothing destructive, stopping preparing for wars, stopping preparing weapons of mass destruction like biological weapons, poisonous gases, nuclear weapons. You can see here, this is a picture from World War II, war with gas, war with fire. We know two nuclear bombs were dropped on Hiroshima and Nagasaki on 6th August and 9th August 1945 during World War II. Green wars, war against nature, or wars fought with green weapons like germs, virus. If wars are fought with such weapons, the victory that people will get would be without any survivors. The whole humankind would die. You can see piles of dead bodies in this picture, and the ground, not a normal ground, burial ground where people are buried. Using weapons of mass destruction would bring disaster in the world. The warmongers would get a victory, but they would not survive to see or celebrate this victory. If these people keep silent and still for 12 seconds, they would make peace. They would walk in shade with their fellow human beings, which they consider their enemies now. Now, the poet thinks that people might mistake him. They might think that the poet does not want human beings to live. He does not want human beings to be active. So he clarifies that what I want should not be confused with total inactivity. The poet does not want total inactivity. He does not want passivity. He cannot support death. Life is what it is about. Life is for living. Life is for being alive, active. Life is to make meaningful actions. I want no truck with death. No truck with death is a phrase. It means to refuse to accept or tolerate death. The poet does not advocate total inactivity and death. He makes it very clear that he refuses to accept death. He believes in life. He believes in activity. What does he want then? He only wants human beings to take some time a very little time out of 12 hours in a day to introspect and retrospect. We should judge our own actions. We should realize what is right and what is wrong. If we were not so single-minded about keeping our lives moving and for once could do nothing, perhaps a huge silence might interrupt this sadness of never understanding ourselves and of threatening ourselves with death. According to the poet Pablo Neruda, there is a sadness in the world for two reasons. One is, human beings do not understand themselves. They fail to understand themselves. And the second reason is that they threaten themselves with death by preparing weapons of mass destruction like nuclear weapons, biological weapons. But this sadness can be disturbed. This sadness can be blocked for some time by keeping silent. When the whole world keeps silent and still, for some moments, there will be a huge silence in the world, which can disturb this sadness. For that, human beings have to stop being single-minded about making materialistic progress. Human beings are running a rat race for money. They want to accumulate material comforts. They want to earn more and more money in the name of progress. If human beings were not so determined or single-minded about making this progress, there would be no problem in the world. There would be no sadness in the world. So the poet makes an appeal to human beings to stop being so single-minded about making progress. He urges them to keep silent and still so that we can disturb the sadness that is prevalent in the world. You can see through this picture, human beings are very determined, single-minded about making progress. They want to move forward in life. They want to scale newer heights every day. The result is that the world is full of sadness due to not understanding ourselves. And there is sadness also due to threatening ourselves with death by preparing for wars. Perhaps the earth can teach us. There is a metaphor here. Earth can be our teacher. Earth has been compared to a teacher. And there is personification also. Earth has been personified. Perhaps the earth can teach us, as when everything seems dead and later proves to be alive. In winter, we see that the earth looks dead. The ground is covered with snow. The trees are leafless. They look lifeless. There are hardly any birds singing. It looks as if the earth were dead. But when spring comes after winter, the earth is again full of life. And in winter also, many activities are going on under the surface of the earth. New seeds are preparing for germination. Now I'll count up to 12 and you keep quiet and I will go. The poet ends the game. He has explained to us the benefits of playing the game. What is the game? The poet will count up to 12 and we all have to keep silent and still for those 12 seconds. And we can reap huge benefits out of this game. The poet, having explained the benefits of the game, now leaves us to play the game. He wants to depart at a note when we all are in a state of quietude, when we are silent and still. You can see the earth looks dead in winter season. But during this season also, you can see many seeds are germinating under the surface of the earth. We cannot see them in winter, but there is life under the dead surface. And when spring comes, it is proven that the earth was not dead in winter. It was very much alive. So earth can be a teacher. It can teach us that there can be life under silence and stillness. Being silent and still does not mean being dead. Having explained the huge benefits of keeping quiet, the poet departs, leaving us in a state of quietude.